Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego. Do 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 do, ba ba ba, do 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 do, do 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 do, do 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 do, ba ba ba, do 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 do.
Now the ones we truly from the land of Israel,
Shadrach and me, Shadrach and Abednego.
They took us into the land of Babylon,
Shadrach and me, Shadrach and Abednego.
And the Nebuchadnezzar was the king of Babylon,
Shadrach and me, Shadrach and Abednego.
They took a little gold and he made him an idol,
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Ooh, oh yeah. Told everybody when you hear the music of the flute, woo woo. Well, they told everybody when you hear the music of the horn.
Boom, doo, boom, doo, boom,
doo, 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 Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
What the children of Israel would
do, 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 Shadrach, and Meshach, Abednego.
You couldn't fool them with that golden idol.
Do, do, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Now I said you couldn't fool them with the golden idol.
Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego.
Joy came to the children in the fiery furnace.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
And he heaped the coal and the red hot brimstone.
Shadrach, Meshach, Shack the Bendigo.
Times hotter, hotter than the old.
Do Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Do 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 Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, home. And the Lord called Gabriel, gave him a couple of wings. He came right down in the middle of the furnace, started to cool the flames. God's children ain't got so happy, they went strutting right through the fire. Laughing and talking about the power of the gospel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Oh, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, home. Oh, Nebuchadnezzar said, what goes on here?
He saw the power of the Lord. Had a big time in the land of Babylon, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
All righty.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I can put this back here now. I'm on lavalier.
All right.
All right. So, good evening and welcome.
What's up with that?
I'm Reverend Dennis Guster Ferry, and this is my co-host, Reverend Joseph McTaggart.
I think she had to sit there next to Joe.
Hold on.
Got to it. And of course, you just heard John. Huh? It's not on.
Try this.
Hello? All right. Go back to this guy. That's cool. Oh, that's what it is. It's not on. Okay. So I'll do this, and when we get out of here, I'll put it back on. That's what happens when you go out live, L-I-V-E, live, on MadhouseTV.com. And you're watching Insight Show. How's that? Now I got power again. I'll put this back. Okay. Are we back on? We got power? Okay, there you go. That's what happens on live TV, folks. You never know what's going to happen. So if you want to learn anything more about what we just sang tonight, Shadrach, and the fiery furnace, you can look up Daniel in the Old Testament. I think it's 3:12 through 30 in Daniel in the Old Testament, and you can find out what that Shadrach's all about. It's really interesting reading. So last week we talked about a bunch of things, and one of the things I talked about was, of course, God, and bringing up the old show, George Burns.
That's right.
Thank God.
Oh God, yeah.
Yeah, oh God. So we want to keep that the theme for tonight. Let's continue to keep that theme. I also commented about God being taken out of things. And I mentioned taking out of churches, which is not churches. I meant to say courts, because I was in a courtroom one day, and I heard them swearing in somebody, and they didn't put that in God, so help me God thing. So it was pretty interesting. I thought that was...
Another place where they're just taking God out of everyday normal life, or life that we all grew up with, in some way, shape, or form, regardless of what you called God. Mine's not working now.
Here, talking to here. talking to my shirt.
How we refer to God, whether it's Jehovah, God, Yahweh, Lord, whatever. Now, this is either way, what we had in the day, what we referred to as God, we keep taking, or the courts, or whoever keeps taking us away from us. And all of us, not just those of us of whatever level of faith that we have, it's just taken away from everybody. And, it kind of makes you wonder why things are going so terribly wrong in the world these days with all the things that never happened when I was a kid growing up.
Well, even taking the I remember a show. How many of you remember Red Skelton? And he did a show. Clap your hands. Yeah, all right. Great man. And he did a skit about how the words under God was added to the Pledge of Allegiance. And he made comment to the fact that wouldn't it be a shame, of course this was later on in the thing, wouldn't it be a shame if they considered that a prayer and took that out of schools? So, what do we have for tonight, my friend?
Well, we have Camille Saturday. All right. She's
your mic is
up. And we're going to speak to her about, I'll try this again. All right, Camille Saturday is here with us tonight in the studio audience.
Maybe we should keep
a fabulous vocalist. She's sung with many groups. She sang with the band that Dennis and I were with years ago. Not that many years ago. She's not that old. And we had a great time with that, with the Sweet Sound Band. And Camille has gone on to other wonderful things in her career, both as an entertainer and as a composer, and also as an actor. She's worked on a wonderful film. And she's gotten some nice awards for that. Also, a very funny comedian, Mike. Mike's over there, Mike Dillon. And he'll be up in a little while. So we'll have a little chat with Mike, and then he'll come up on the stage and make us all laugh a little bit. Maybe a lot.
That would be nice.
That would be nice. So.
As I'm still trying to set up house over here.
And of course, Reverend Dennis, you're going to sing a song for us, right?
I certainly am.
Okay. Do you know what it is?
Surprise me.
Oh, you're going to surprise us.
I don't know. You never know what's going to happen. Like I said, it's live TV on madhouse.com, madhousetv.com. And this is the Inside Show. Oh, yes. So if you'll cue up my little band over here. Oh, I know what this is.
Hold you in my arms. In
knowing my heart and mind, that no matter come what may, love will survive. Love, the author of space and time, keeps the galaxies and each sparrow alive. And the love that heals the wound after the war is through is the knight in armor bright, faithful and true to you. A darling pearl, I will be the one to hold you in my arms. Thank you so much. We're going to go back for a second. We'll be right back after these words.
Hey, I'm Tom Mealy from the Harrison Law Group. You know, soft tissue injury, that's no joke. This is what we do. We're not new at this game. Don't waste valuable time going to firms who don't get it and can't do it. Call 1-800-INJURY-LAW.
Brooklyn's best locksmith and hardware.
We have three of the largest showrooms of safes on display and in stock. You can see and touch them in person instead of browsing a catalog. We carry gun and rifle safes, burglary safes, jewelry safes, fire rated from a half hour to 2 hours. Famous name brands.
We sell Gardol.
We sell AmSAC.
The new AmSAC touchscreen.
If you're ever in need of a safe, think Brooklyn's best locksmith and hardware. Right, Lockie?
That's right, Alan.
For professional motorcycle transport and towing, think Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing. Proudly serving all of Long Island, we feature expert handling and 24/7 service. So send a limo for your toy with Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing.
This is Beth.
Hi.
Oh, congratulations. When are you due?
I'm not pregnant.
Oh, look at that. Excuse me.
You're totally thin.
You look very sexy.
For life's bleachable moments, all it takes is 3/4 cup.
Ray, I don't know. Are you sure clicking this thing will get us online?
Well, try dragging it. Faster. You're just a mouse click away from a better way to rent movies. Blockbuster Total Access. Movies through the mail plus movies through the store. One low price.
Here's the problem. We forgot to plug it in.
Oh, don't even think about it.
Get a free trial at your Blockbuster store or Blockbuster.com.
So then I said, Mr. Prime Minister, I'm flattered that you love chocolate, but I'm here strictly in a professional. What's wrong with him?
He thinks you're naked.
My shell is brown. It just looks like my milk chocolate is showing. Only a fool would think I'd actually show up naked.
So it's that kind of party. Hit it.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Okay, and we're back, and see if we got all those bugs out of that live TV here on the Insight Show, here on MadhouseTV.com. We hope you're enjoying it so far, you're sticking around. We are 90 minutes long from now on in, so this is a great thing for us. I'd like to also let you know that we have with us tonight a comedian, Mike Dillon. Welcome to our show, Mike. How are you doing?
Nice to be here, Dennis, and congratulations on the 90 minutes. That's absolutely great.
Yeah, I feel like Johnny Carson now. I
guess. That's it. If you can get Johnny to appear, that would even be...
I'm not a magician.
A bigger coup.
You're not that good.
Okay. That's okay.
I wouldn't put it past my crew, though, Tommy and all the other people there.
I'll just try to do a couple of his jokes. Maybe that'll bring him back.
So how long have you been doing this, Mike?
Dennis, 13 years in the business. I started as a stand-up. Now I produce a lot of shows also.
Oh, great.
Out on Long Island and Farmingville, presently at the Gateway Comedy Club.
Oh, cool. So you have a lot of comedians under your belt as well?
Like, oh, boy.
Dennis Ross and stuff?
Some nights more comedians than audience, Dennis. I hate to admit that. But
we know that.
There's
too.
A million comics out there.
I understand you also sing.
I'm also, where did you get that information from? You sound like James Lipton now. Where did you get that information from?
I have my ways.
I've done some singing also, yes. I have a pretty good voice, believe it or not. Maybe someday
you'll let me come in here and turn all your
customers away.
Well, the standards and stuff like that?
Mostly, yes. American songbook type of thing. You know, Sinatra and Tony Bennett. And
we had Sinatra here the other week, Charlie Ganji.
Okay, great. So, I've heard of Charlie. I hear he's great.
I
thought you actually had the real Sinatra here.
He's really good.
And then we could bring the Carson in there. We bring back the whole 60s and 70s.
But anyway, now that I know that you sing, maybe we can get you back here.
I'd love to. Love to sing. Every singer wants to do comedy. Every comic wants to sing.
That's true. I would like to do that, but I'm afraid people are going to laugh at me. So I didn't.
But what happens, Dennis, with me is I get a straight-faced response when I do comedy, and I get the laughter when I'm singing. That's how it works.
I know that feeling, too, as a matter of fact.
What are you going to do?
So where are you going to be performing next after this great show?
Our next show, I have a show up in, let's see, ask my wife. I'm up at the Turning Stone Casino in Verona, New York, coming up in July 24th, and then... in August, I'm up at Joker's Wild up in New Haven, Connecticut. Great city, folks. Try to stay away from there. And I also have a show coming up this coming July the 20th. I should have brought my notes. July 27th at the Flaming Hearth in Farmingville. We have an open mic contest where we let people try it out. Yeah. I mean, everybody has to start someplace.
Have you ever done what's the name of that place, Joe? Reverend Joe, the where we go to the comedy acts. Where, matter of fact, I think Frank Prince.
Oh, Frankie Prince.
He is also on Madhouse. Governors. That's
I've worked all these clubs, and now they've kicked me out. No, I've worked all these clubs, and you know it's just like Macy's and Bloomingdale's. Once you start producing your own shows, they kind of really don't want you around so much. So.
I know that feeling too.
A little bit of competition. is good, though. Competition, I think, is always good. Keeps raising the level of the talent.
Well, so what is your next step from here? I mean, you mentioned you were playing over. What was the next date?
Going to the Islip Diner after here for a half.
All right. Because we're going to go over to the diner over here. What's the name of that diner?
Yeah, we're going to go.
You come with us after it's over.
What was it, the Olympic Diner? We'll probably do a couple of songs over there.
Great.
Yeah, we've got quite a following over there among the wait staff, so we'll see what happens.
My actual show next is in, like I said, in Farmingville at Gateway Comedy. GatewayComedy.com is the website. And like I said, we have professional comics as well as amateurs who bring people in. And you have to start somewhere. I started in, I'm trying to remember my first show. It was at a club in Bohemia. I remember getting on stage for the first time. Of course, you're going to be nervous. And getting through halfway through the first joke and totally forgetting the punchline and looking out at the audience and asking them, does anybody know the punchline of this joke? Because I don't know the show. But I kept coming back, and like I said, 13 years later, I'm still a nobody.
Well, no, you're a somebody here. You're a star here, that's for sure. But anyway, we're gonna give you a chance to come up there and do your stuff for us.
That's great.
A little later on in the show.
Appreciate it.
But first, we're gonna go to a commercial, and then we're gonna have somebody, another person over here that I know very well. So. Looking forward to seeing you act. So we'll be back with you in a few minutes after these words.
One resident describes her horrifying experience when she first realized the complex was on fire.
I got bronchitis. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Well, I woke up to go give me a cold pop. Then I thought somebody was barbecuing. I said, oh Lord Jesus, it's a fire. Then I ran out, I didn't grab no shoes or nothing. Jesus, I'm running for my life. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Tom Mealy from the Harrison Law Group. You know, soft tissue injury, that's no joke. This is what we do. We're not new at this game. Don't waste valuable time going to firms who don't get it and can't do it. Call 1-800-INJURY-LAW.
Ray, I don't know. Are you sure clicking this thing will get us online?
Well, try dragging it. Faster.
You're just a mouse click away from a better way to rent movies. Blockbuster Total Access. Movies through the mail plus movies through the store. One low price.
Here's the problem. We forgot to plug it in.
Oh, don't even think about it.
Get a free trial at your Blockbuster store or Blockbuster.com.
We'll be right back. and we're back. Thank you for sticking around. You're watching The Inside Show on MadhouseTV.com. I'm Reverend Dennis, if you're just tuning in. I have somebody out here sitting down that I really, really, I love her. What can I say? She's a sweetheart of a lady. We have a history together, musically. And so, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to introduce you right now to Camille Saturday on Thursday.
That's right. Thank you.
We got a couple of weekends in there or something, a couple of weekdays.
I know, and I'm happy to be here, and congratulations on the show.
Well,
I feel this is so exciting. You know, Johnny and Ed here.
They're both deceased. I mean, it's like
It's just bringing it back. It's cool.
But Reverend Joe and myself know Camille very well. We sang together in a group called Sweet Sound Band. Matter of fact,
we did.
I don't know if you can get a copy of this at all. Can we zoom in on this at all, any chance? Let's see. Or not. Okay.
Not.
We're going to try.
All right, we're going to try. I just sprung this on them. It's live TV, and that's what happens.
Read it louder.
Oh, how is that nice? That's Sweet Sound Band. And that's Camille right there.
Yeah, sitting right in the front, next to Reverend Dennis there.
That's right.
You're going to get to hear us sing later.
And I noticed you have a photo of Richie B.
Yeah, and also Ralph.
And Ralph, who we miss very much, actually.
They passed from cancer.
They were really great.
Nice,
great sax player, wonderful bass player. Yeah, and we had a lot of fun.
And Joe played trumpet, among other horns.
Yep.
You always hear John Roper talking about different horns he plays and bass piccolos and all that stuff.
Right.
Don't make
fun
of my bass piccolo, you.
The last time that we were together, I believe, was 2007, which is amazing. But I'd like to show you a clip of something that we go back in 2004, when we were doing with the Sweet Sound Band. We played Patchogue Theater.
That was a fun night. It was, and it was a very successful evening, and we had a lot of fun.
Well, I have a clip of here of you singing Maybe.
Really?
Yes, and I want
to
play it.
Wonderful. I'd love
maybe
to
not.
See that.
Well, maybe not.
So with no.
For you. Here we go. Thank you.
A little intro.
What was that?
You said I should have my own, what was it, my own?
Theme song.
Yeah, that was. I'll have
that theme song just auditioned.
I'm going to write one for Dennis.
Oh, my, that was terrific. I was going to say that was so good. You sounded terrific on it.
Everybody was a great memory. And
it was magic in the air.
It was just a great night. And I think it was the night that we did the benefit for the Iraq soldiers,
yes,
right?
That's correct.
It was a benefit for the soldiers.
Specifically, three specific ones.
That's right.
And then all
that
the others.
Lost,
yeah.
Yes. That we lost. So it was a touching evening. And, you know, music is soothing to people. And, you know, I think everybody really enjoyed it and had a good time.
Well, we've always gotten in, including, you know, as us and by yourself as well. We've always gotten involved in charity events. We do the Wounded Warriors every year. Which is coming up again.
July 21st in Long Beach. At the Long Beach Regional Catholic School. In the middle of the afternoon, we're going to have all the vets that are going to be there. They're going to be flying people in from all over the country for this event. There'll be a parade before the show over at the school. We should have a great time.
We've done it for the last 3 or 4 years.
That's right. Bravo. And last year was the first year it didn't rain. Hopefully we go two in a row.
We
drew monsoons.
We were outside. The food was under the tent, and we were outside in the rain.
That's right. And if you can imagine what a vocal group sounds like singing underwater, well, that's what we were doing that day.
Now, Camille, there's something going on with you now. I understand that your latest video, Secret Detective.
I have a video out. It's called Secret Detective. It's an original tune.
It was accepted in the Long Island...
Yes, it was accepted into the Long Island International Film Expo. Dennis has a little trouble with that.
It's not as bad as trying to say the website.
LIFilmExpo.org.
That sounds pretty terrific.
I'm very excited about it.
Tell me a little bit about it.
Yeah, the Long Island International Film Expo is it's a pretty large film expo, and they have everyone, filmmakers, producers, directors, actors from all over the country could enter, and it's a really great networking tool, and I'm really proud to be a part of it. As a matter of fact, the video will be screened July 17th, if anybody's interested in getting tickets.
Oh, really?
It's at the Belmore Theater, and it's the evening of July 17th, so I'm very excited about it. It's an original tune written by myself, Irv Berner, and John Bennett.
Irv was our
lead guitarist in the Sweet Sound Band. He's a great guitarist. You can go to my website, CamilleSaturday.com, to hear more music and see what I'm up to.
Well, yeah, that sounds good. You got something planned coming up soon as well, but we'll get back to that in a second. Let's go to this. We have it here first. Before you have to see it in the movies.
You're getting a whole view of it here.
We're going to give you a shot of it right now. So
I get to see it in the studio. Cool.
Yeah, I've seen a little bit of it before. I love it. So
it's fun.
Let's see it.
Okay.
the cuff me so bad, you had to find a way. Hide behind the shield you wear, but there's nothing good in there. Evil and heartache, the gifts you bear.
I guess we got an abridged version of this seat of your. Well, you know what? They're just going to have to go to Belmore Theater.
They're going to, because it is sort of a surprise ending. So if the ending wasn't seen right now, I guess it's going to be.
We kept it a little secret, a little surprise.
We're keeping it more of a secret than.
A secret detective that gets deserves
right.
A secret.
It was actually, sparked by a true story. Which I won't get into right now.
Was it a true Long Island story or a true story
somewhere
else? No,
actually, it was a story out in California.
Oh, okay.
A friend of mine was out there and just inspired me to write this tune.
What's scaring me is I know the ending.
It's true. Dennis knows the ending.
And I'm like, wait a minute. Well, I tell you what, we're gonna regroup here a little bit. We're gonna have Mike come up and entertain you with some wonderful comedy. Right after these words, we're going to take a little break and be back in a few seconds.
One resident describes her horrifying experience when she first realized the complex was on fire.
I got bronchitis. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time for that. Well, I woke up to go and give me a cold pop. Then I thought somebody was barbecuing. I said, oh Lord Jesus, it's a fire. Then I ran out, I didn't grab no shoes or nothing, Jesus. I ran for my life. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Jesus,
ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time.
Welcome to Shoreline Beverage. We are located on New York Avenue in Huntington, just 1/2 mile north of the Huntington Station for Long Island Railroad. Shoreline Beverage is Long Island's preeminent beverage distributor, specializing in a wide variety of beer, soda, and related items. With our huge selection of craft and imported beer, along with Long Island's largest array of non-alcoholic beverages and soft drinks, you will agree, Shoreline Beverage is your number one source for all your beverage needs. We also supply ice, kegs, chips, and other snack foods, making Shoreline Beverage a convenient one-stop shopping experience. We offer a huge assortment of cold beverages and feature Long Island's first growler station, serving up 5 fresh beers on tap for your enjoyment. Be sure to check out our website to see what is currently on tap. Our friendly and courteous staff will assist you in every way in order to make every visit to Shoreline Beverage a pleasurable experience. So remember, make Shoreline Beverage your only choice when it comes to your beverage needs. Mention this commercial and receive the free gift on your next visit.
For professional motorcycle transport and towing, think Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing. Proudly serving all of Long Island, we feature expert handling and 24/7 service. So send a limo for your toy with Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing.
Thank you. We're back. That wasn't too long. All right. Before we continue, I'd like to thank our friends over at Signorama over on 150 Fulton Street over in Farmingdale. They did this beautiful banner that's up on the wall here that mentions the Insight Show. You don't really get to see it too much because we're standing in front of it. But there it is. And thanks again to the guys over at Signorama for that. Also, I'd like to thank our crews we do every week, Tom Mealy, Vicky Mealy, Tom Marr, and Janine Zarilli. And I actually remembered her last name, and that wasn't easy, but I'd like to thank them also. They've done a terrific job. So, all right, on that note, let's get to the funny part of the show. Mike Dillon's here.
You want me to leave? Is that it?
Now, that would be fun. Mike's here to entertain us, give us some of his version of comedy. I'm sure we're all going to enjoy it. And he had us all cracking up here before the show started tonight, so...
We go. That was the best part of my act, by the way. Thanks, Joe.
You're on, Mike.
How about a nice hand for Dennis, too? Madhouse TV, this is great. Any comics out there, this is a first-rate thing going on here. Certainly contact Dennis at Madhouse and get up here. This is great. We have a little audience, but I'm telling you, a lot better than last night's show. I performed at a senior home last night. Yeah. I don't want to say these people were old, but I made reference to that old social network, MySpace. They thought I was talking about their cemetery plots. So it's nice to see people actually breathing and laughing for a change. Something tells me I'm going to get the exact same response, though. There's like 6 people in the audience. But it's great. A little about myself. I recently went back to hitting the gym. Beam. Yep. Something tells me I'm going to be using it a lot tonight, in fact. But I am going back to the gym. I actually am going to a place. I go to Planet Fitness. Planet Fitness, anybody? Planet Fitness? Nobody goes to the gym here. This is the unhealthiest crowd I've ever performed in front of. Planet Fitness is great. $10 a month. No commitment. Perfect. Cheap, and I don't have to go. My wife's behind me 100% getting better. She got me a personal trainer. She loves it. Now I pee on the newspaper every time. Sometimes when she's reading it. How about a nice hand for my wife? She's actually in the crowd tonight. That's about as loud as it's going to get, folks. Like I said, there's 6 people. But I have lost 120 pounds over the last couple of years. Is that amazing? Great. And people are fascinated by these weight loss shows. You know, they always say, how do you do it? How do you lose 120 pounds? I tell them, liposuction. I said, no, you mean liposuction. No, liposuction. The Long Island Power Authority is charging me so much for electricity, I can't afford to eat. Always one wise guy, too. You lost 120 pounds. What'd you do, dump your wife? I said, no, that'd be 220. I'll leave me and my wife out of this. I love her just the way they are. Like I said, she's right here tonight. First get married
things go great. After a couple of years, hey, you know, it gets a little dull. You know, I saw her this morning at the dinner, at the breakfast table. I said, you have your wedding band on the wrong finger. She said, that's because I married the wrong husband. You first go out and you have pet names for one another, right? My wife used to call me her Jiffy Lube. I'm like, that's because I'm like a professional. She said, no, that's because you always in and out and done in under 10 minutes. So I'm your husband. Oh. Leave me alone. After all, you guys married, Joe, Dennis, anybody? Anybody amongst the six that are married here tonight? Your first marriage, you know, you have, things go great. Eventually you have a fight and you have makeup sex. It happens to all marriages. You have, you fight, you make up, you have sex, right? My wife and I never had that kind of time. So we'd fight during sex. You call that foreplay? You call that faking it? We go on separate vacations now, Joe. Separate vacations. Last year she went to Europe. I took a trip to the liquor store. My vacation costs more. This year she's going to Reno. I'm going to rehab. Married parents here tonight? There's only six people. Nobody's a parent. Nobody goes to the gym. Why do I expect a response from six people here, Joe, what do I expect? I got kids. They were wrecking my yard last summer. I'm like, get off the lawn. Get off the lawn. My wife, you know, we're raising children here, not grass. I said, oh, yeah? That's marijuana growing out there. She's like, get off the lawn. Get off the lawn right now. She's a pothead. I can't help it. I married a pothead. I got a son, typical Irishman, drunk, out of work. He's 13. Typical Irish kid, too. He's got the flaming red hair, the big brown freckles. Funniest looking black kid on the block. I know. I'm only gone 50 weeks out of the year. She can't be loyal to me. Problem with getting married, though, is people change. Look at me. I'm not the same guy anymore. I'm certainly not attractive anymore. My wife, when I first married, I got attracted. She had the shape of an hourglass. And I love playing in the sand. Now she has the shape of a milk bottle. And I'm lactose intolerant. All I'm saying is she's no longer low fat. I don't know if you noticed, folks, stand up, my wife. Stand up. That's Donna, my wife. My wife is a midget. She actually is a midget. I married her because she's very thrifty. On the day that we, on our wedding day, to save money, she stood on the wedding cake. She. I had a fight with her on the way over here tonight. I said, I had to ride up here with you. Getting back to my kids, I got a son, like I said. Big thing nowadays is sleepovers. These kids want to go on sleepovers. Folks, guys, 6 years. It's dangerous. I laid the law down to my son. No booze, no broads, no drugs. But if you do, make sure it's not tequila. Wear a rubber and bring a pot for your mother. Wanted to go to camp. Camp is expensive. Anybody with kids here in the camp age? Nobody. Nobody goes to the gym. Nobody's got kids. You guys don't do nothing here. My kid wanted to, it's expensive. I looked around. I finally found one we all can afford. Summer school. Hey, Dad, I want to play baseball vacation. I said, well, that's your fault. Next year, flunk gym. I got a teenage daughter, 19 years old, already, Joe, making more money than I am. Yeah, maybe I can get a job at Hooters. Is that where your daughter works at Hooters? I got the poll already. My daughter learned about sex when she was 5 years old. This is what they do now. They teach sex education in school now when they're 5 years old. She comes home. Boys have peanuts and girls have China. What is this? I'm a father. Well, I had to set it straight. You're close, honey. Your daddy has walnuts. And your mother has a nutcracker. He hasn't let me use the good China in years. I'm surprised you guys actually laughed at that. It's a little dirty, but I'm in my midlife crisis. I'm in my midlife crisis, right? It's not all these early bird specials and early tea times. You're constantly going to the doctor, and it's always the same thing. Drop your pants. I want to check your prostate. Is this normal from your dentist? I mean, I got a pacemaker now, too. Things get bad. You'll constantly go, I got a pacemaker. Not the worst thing in the world, but it only lasts, educational part of the show, folks, it lasts nine years. It goes bad. I think mine's finally going on the fritz. Now, when I watch TV and I fart, the channel changes. I'm getting so good at it, I threw out the remote. In fact, I'm changing stations at my house right now. I'm channel surfing. My name is Mike Dillon. Thanks so much again, Madhouse TV, Joe and Dennis. Comics, come on out. It's a first-rate run place.
Thanks, Mike. That was great. You have to work on that thing about getting rid of the remote at home for the cable. But folks, we'll be right back after a couple of messages. We're going to change things around here a little bit, and Camille's going to come up and perform for us as well. So we'll be back in a little bit.
Hey, I'm Tom Mealy from the Harrison Law Group. You know, soft tissue injury, that's no joke. This is what we do. We're not new at this game. Don't waste valuable time going to firms who don't get it and can't do it. Call 1-800-INJURY-LAW.
Huntington Toyota, the experience of a lifetime. Don't take our word for it.
The experience for me at Huntington Toyota made me feel very comfortable.
It's their professionalism, their honesty, and their integrity. I've bought at least 9 of 10 cars here at Huntington Toyota. They give me the best price around.
It never was about high pressure. It never was about them. It was always about us.
Today's cars are very similar, but Huntington Toyota is very different.
Huntington Toyota, where it's all about you.
Standing here with Camille Saturday, and she is going to take it away. Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, for Camille Saturday.
Thank you. Gonna be the whole 90 yards on the wind.
Stop thinking about you, baby, and how you'd hold me tight.
Hold me tight.
I couldn't stop thinking about you, baby, and how you smile so right.
Smile so right.
And as I kept on walking, I knew I'd be coming home. And don't you know that when we fight, you know I can't stop thinking of you lying over there.
Over there.
In the bed where I left you. Tossing, turning all alone.
All alone.
And cause you drive me so crazy, I know I'll be coming home.
Over there.
And cause you drive me so crazy, I know I'll be coming home.
Camille Saturday.
Thank you very much.
Don't forget to watch that. Go over to the Belmore Theater over there and catch that.
Yeah, and you can catch more originals on my website at CamilleSaturday.com.
Yeah, those are both original
tunes.
Songs. Yes. There's Camille Saturday.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me here.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
I had a lot of fun.
We'll have you come back again.
I definitely will come back again.
Terrific.
I'm too much of a ham to stay away.
Well, I tell you what, we're gonna stay away. We're going to take a little commercial break. We'll be right back in a minute or two, and we have another surprise. Well, not a surprise. Reverend Joe is going to be doing some singing for you.
Yay.
All right. Stick around.
Feeling from the Harrison Law Group. You know, soft tissue injury, that's no joke. This is what we do. We're not new at this game. Don't waste valuable time going to firms who don't get it and can't do it. Call 1-800-INJURY-LAW.
Huntington Toyota, the experience of a lifetime. Don't take our word for it.
The experience for me at Huntington Toyota made me feel very comfortable.
It's their professionalism, their honesty, and their integrity. I've bought at least 9 or 10 cars here at Huntington Toyota. They give me the best price around.
It never was about high pressure. It never was about them. It was always about us.
Today's cars are very similar, but Huntington Toyota is very different.
Huntington Toyota, where it's all about you.
Brooklyn's best locksmith and hardware.
We have three of the largest showrooms of safes on display and in stock. You can see and touch them in person instead of browsing a catalog. We carry gun and rifle safes, burglary safes, jewelry safes, fire rated from a half hour to 2 hours. Famous name brands.
We sell Gardaw.
We sell AmSAC.
The new AmSAC touchscreen.
If you're ever in need of a safe, think Brooklyn's best locksmith and hardware. Right, Lockie?
That's right, Alan.
Welcome to Shoreline Beverage. We are located on New York Avenue in Huntington, just 1/2 mile north of the Huntington Station for Long Island Railroad. Shoreline Beverage is Long Island's preeminent beverage distributor, specializing in a wide variety of beer, soda, and related items. With our huge selection of craft and imported beer, along with Long Island's largest array of non-alcoholic beverages and soft drinks, you will agree, Shoreline Beverage is your number one source for all your beverage needs. We also supply ice, kegs, chips, and other snack foods, making Shoreline Beverage a convenient one-stop shopping experience. We offer a huge assortment of cold beverages and feature Long Island's first growler station, serving up 5 fresh beers on tap for your enjoyment. Be sure to check out our website to see what is currently on tap. Our friendly and courteous staff will assist you in every way in order to make every visit to Shoreline Beverage a pleasurable experience. So remember, make Shoreline Beverage your only choice when it comes to your beverage needs. Mention this commercial and receive the free gift on your next visit to Shoreline Beverage.
Thanks for sticking around. And I'm up here because my boss, Reverend Dennis, has asked me to sing a song. So once the band starts playing, I'll start singing.
This affair never would go so well. But why am I trying to think that time I know so well that I've got you under my skin? I'd sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of the warning voice that comes in the night and repeats every beat in my ear. Don't you know, you fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. But each time I do, just another year makes me stop before I begin. 'Cause I've got you. love the way the band builds up like this. Isn't this great? Especially my favorite part, because I'm partial to it, and that's the horns. So, fasten your seatbelt. Here they come. Sake of having you near, in spite of that warning voice that comes in the night, every beat repeats in my ear. Don't you know, you fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. But each time thank you. Well, that was fun. There's nothing wrong with a little Frank Sinatra any time of the day or night. So, all right, stick around. We're going to take a break for a few messages and rearrange things a little bit. And I believe we're going to hear some from the Bob Knight 4 coming up, as always. So stick around, and we'll be right back.
Old Spice Body Spray will make you feel so powerful to blow your mind right in front of your face.
Goodbye.
Oh, no!
Automatic freshness, softness, and static control has never been easier with the Bounce Dryer Bar. I just stick it to the inside of my dryer, and I never have to remember.
Oh, Old Spice Body Spray makes you smell like power! It's so powerful, it sells itself in other people's commercials! You smell like outdoor freshness.
You smell like power?
Yeah, I do! Power!
Try this routine to feel fresh and clean. Pair Charmin Freshmates with your Charmin.
Oh, Old Spice Body Spray is too powerful to stay in its own commercial! That's right. Power!
Now, how is this? Wow, you know what? I actually do feel more power.
Potato chips! Power! It's me!
Brooklyn's best locksmith and hardware.
We have three of the largest showrooms of safes on display and in stock. You can see and touch them in person instead of browsing a catalog. We carry gun and rifle safes, burglary safes, jewelry safes, fire rated from a half hour to 2 hours. Famous name brands.
We sell Gardol.
We sell AMSAC.
The new AMSAC touchscreen.
If you're ever in need of a safe, think Brooklyn's best locksmith and hardware. Right, Lockie?
That's right, Alan.
Ray, I don't know. Are you sure clicking this thing will get us online?
Well, try dragging it. Faster.
You're just a mouse click away from a better way to rent movies. Blockbuster Total Access. Movies through the mail plus movies through the store. One low price.
Here's the problem. We forgot to plug it in.
Oh, don't even think about it.
Get a free trial at your Blockbuster store or Blockbuster.com.
Thank you.
Roper and the Bob Knight Four.
Songs for the price of one in there. What a bargain.
What's this? This is the Drifters, isn't it?
It's the Drifters. That is your favorite group.
Yeah, my favorite.
You get to sing the lead.
I get to sing the lead on this.
Just drift back over to the corner over there.
Listen, nice arrangement that John actually did. He did all the arrangements. It's nice. I like it, especially the bongos. When this old world starts getting me down, people are just too much for me to face.
Up on the roof,
I climb way up to the top of the stairs, and all my cares just drift right into space.
Up on the roof,
on the roof it's peaceful as can be, and there the world below don't bother me. Down in the street,
up on the roof,
on the roof, the only place I know, where you just have to wish to make it so. Let's go. Oh, when the sun beats down and burns the tar upon the roof, and your shoes get so hot, you wish your tired feet were fireproof. Under the boardwalk, down by the sea, yeah. On a blanket with my baby, is where I'll be.
Under the boardwalk,
up the sun.
Trouble
through
up on the roof,
and if this- on the roof.
Up on the roof.
Up on the roof.
Up on the roof.
Come on, baby.
Up on the roof.
Up, come on, honey.
Up on the roof.
Way up on the roof. Way. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back after these short little messages.
Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Thank you.
One resident describes her horrifying experience when she first realized the complex was on fire.
I got bronchitis. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time, ain't nobody got time for that. Well, I woke up to go give me a cold pop. Then I thought somebody was barbecuing, barbecuing, barbecuing. I said, oh Lord Jesus, it's a fire. Then I ran out, I didn't grab no shoes or nothing, Jesus. I'm ready for my life. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, and we are back. Thank you so much for sticking around. And for you guys at home, thank you for sticking around. You've been a great audience. I hope you had fun with the show tonight. I did, with all the mishaps and everything. I just want to let you know that July 4th, we are not going to be here tonight. They may be playing another one of our shows or whatever, but July 4th is a holiday, so we won't be here. But the next show, it's lovely, is July 11th. And for that show, we have a comedian by the name of Billy Billy Bingo, okay? I'm going to read this because it's kind of tough as it is. We're having a contest, a karaoke contest, with this gentleman by the name of Russell Targov. He was over in King Yum, and we're using his people. He's going to have four people up here, and we're going to have it judged, and they're going to win. And King Yum is sponsoring it with $300 for the winner. All right. So we'll be that on the 11th. So we'll see you then. Meanwhile, as we usually end the show, I went out of camera for a second, but I did it for a reason. So here we go with my music maestro. I want to thank you, everybody, for sticking around. I want to give my props to God and country.
God bless America.
From the mountains to the prairies to the ocean, why would fall? God bless America, my own sweet home. Ladies and gentlemen out there, please give your props to the police departments and the fire departments and to our first responders and to our soldiers who are out there defending our freedom and for the veterans who've been there and done it. Ladies and gentlemen, the greatest country in the world, sing it out nice and loud with me. Come on, everybody. America, our home sweet home. God bless America. God bless America. God. Good night, everybody. God bless.